It is not in other part of the world. It is only in India. Or maybe it is South Asian country.
Sir, if a patient, on the patient's repeated complaints, if, as I hear today, there is a provision that a doctor can be arrested, don't you think that it will increase the fear amongst the doctor, which will finally harm the patient? Because till we are bold in our decisions, we will not be able to do the justice. So I feel 304 is in contradiction, I may be wrong, before the senior judge of section 88. What is your opinion on this?
Right, but if you say 304A cannot be applied, then what can be applied?
304 I said, sir.
No, Dr. 304 in normal circumstances, I don't think it is applied. I do not know what transpired in the Sundarlal Jain hospital's case.
There's one more thing.
Doctor, I do not know. See, it cannot be blanket. Sections I can prescribe, or you cannot prescribe medicines like
Excuse me. Sir, after this incident of Sundarlal Hospital, probably there was a judgment which said that 304A cannot be applied on the doctor. It will be 304B if necessary.
Doctor, मैं वही कह रहा हूँ कि अगर normal circumstances 304A ही लगता है, अगर 304 लगाया है, देखिए हम लोग लगाते हैं, we cannot go personal कि मुझे डॉक्टर को आज टिकाना है. It doesn't happen that way. Like you don't treat patients कि आज इसको मैंने fit करना है. It is absolutely unprofessional. अगर 304 लगाई है, जरूर कुछ ना कुछ कहानी रही हो. I do not know. I cannot comment on that. And why दो केस बता रहे हो सकते हैं इंडिया में और 200-500 केसेस हों. But what is more important is, जैसे एक केस में डॉक्टर चतुर्वेदी बता रहे थे, the courts turned it down. It would have been on merits. लेकिन बाकी केसेस में क्या हुआ? 304 did it stand the final trial and did it lead to the conviction of the doctors? That's important. If it went through, then 304 was called for and it was absolutely correct. So let us not debate on what is 304. Let us understand the contents and when it should be applied. You should be aware. Basically, let us be aware of what is 304A. That is a section which concerns you more than anything else. So focus on 304A.
I think we can stop this discussion here. It's a very long discussion. We can have the queries during the tea break. And to summarize all this, there is a lot of apprehension which is out of the context amongst the doctors regarding 304A or 304 or 304B, which is really not that in the actuality. And we should not be so scared. If we are doing our work correctly, rightly, in the patient's interest, there is no need to be scared of all these things. Because we, majority of the doctors, they are practicing and they have seen that if they are in confidence of the patient, they are with the confidence of the surroundings and everyone, and properly explain the outcome of the event to the patient, relations and everyone, they don't go like this. Leave aside only one or two stray incidences where there are mob, they come to the hospital. We have seen in our Max hospital also. They come, they cry, and they create a scene over there. They have broken the windows, they have broken the gates also. But ultimately, nothing happens to the doctor. And majority of the doctors, they are quite safe. That's what I can derive from their discussion. Thank you very much, Dr. Pawan.
I would like to add to it, just 2 minutes, ma'am. There's a law in Delhi and in many other states in India where you have a provision of law which says it is prevention of violence and damage to property. It is 2008. Now, this special act came into force only with respect to the healthcare institutions. Now, it safeguards not only the doctors, the institutions, it is also safeguarding the entire staff of the hospital or of the educational institution, including the paramedics. Now, what I find in this act, that there's a provision, if you destroy a property of the hospital, you are liable to get a punishment extending from 3 to 10 years. It is 3 years.
But when the police comes to the scene, they say that doctor, koi baat nahi, ye to mareez ke attendant se overreaction ho gaya, chhod dijiye, koi baat nahi, haan bachde mein pad rahe. This is the normal sentences which we see here from the police people. In spite of the fact that they slap the doctors, they humiliate the nurses and other staff, they create scenes in the hospital and the police arrive, they try to pacify the doctor or shift the blame to the doctor.
No, this is not a case. I was on night duty. It was Subhash Day. It was 2011. Now, what happened was, there was a case when a guy, there was a death. Now, there was a PCR van passing by. The guy said that this guy who died had some, you know, money or financial dealings with some, the guy who was alleged that he killed him. Now, how theory started, that there was a PCR van, they failed to intervene when he met with an accident. Actually, it was an accident. His, he was in an SUV which turned over thrice, and because of head injury, multiple injuries, he finally expired. Because of that PCR van, we came into the picture. That police ne mil ke isko marwa diya. I was there on the night duty. So it started around 11, 12 o'clock, and then I got a call. So it was Max, this Subhash place. I went there. So unhone kya kiya, they called the media channels, they called all the relatives, aurte aa gaye, they called my meri matlab vardi phad apne ko ho gaye the us raat ko. It was 4 o'clock in the morning. They never allowed us even to shift his body to the mortuary. Everything failed. Finally, then I had to call the force. Yeah, I'll lat maar ke tumhe bahar nikalunga. That issue came. Then entire thing, you know, doctors were part. It came on the police. Yeah, inko dekhte hain. So all the media, everything was against us. Now, what happened? We registered a case under this act. Ye pehla case humne diya. Ye inko jo hai na establishment jo toda Max Hospital mein. Isme dono answers ho jayenge. Doctor aapka bhi ho jayega. Humne case de diya. फिर इनके माँ बाप आए और औरतें आई सिफारिश करती है कि देखो यंग बच्चा है, इसकी ज़िंदगी खराब हो जाएगी जी, इसको क्या है ऑल दैट. तो फाइनली वो ऊपर से हेडक्वार्टर से कमिश्नर से सिफारिश करते करते नीचे हमारे तक आ गए. तो व्हेन दे एंटर्ड माय रूम आई सेड सर आई वाज देयर, आई एम अ विटनेस, व्हाटएवर दे मे से आई एम अ विटनेस टू व्हाट दे डिड इन द हॉस्पिटल. और मैं उनका रोल बता देता था, भाई ये तुमने किया. अल्टीमेटली आई बुक्ड 6 बॉयज, दे stood the trial. I do not know finally क्या हुआ, but they were behind bars 3-4 महीने तो जेल में रहे लड़के, यंग लड़के थे. और मीडिया वालों ने भी कुछ नहीं किया क्योंकि उनके पुजारों के नाम उन्हें डाले थे. बट अल्टीमेटली वॉट हैपन, फाइनली डॉक्टर्स फिर हमारे पास आए कि सर आपने क्या कर दिया, हमें फंसा दिया. मैंने क्या किया, बोलता हमें रोज कोर्ट जाना पड़ता है, हम पेशेंट देखे हैं कोर्ट में आए, आपने एडवाइस ही नहीं दिया, हमें पहले बता देते हैं पकड़े नहीं फंसते. सो डॉक्टर दोनों चीजें इट्स, देखिए आपको ओटी में रहना है, आपको दिक्कत नहीं होगी. हमें तो कोर्ट कचहरी में जजेस के सामने गाली खानी है, वी आर यूज्ड टू इट, इट इज आवर जॉब, वी आर बीइंग पेड फॉर दैट. द पेन विल बी सफर्ड बाय यू पीपल, यू डिसाइड, वी विल बी विद यू. और देयर इज अ स्मॉल सेइंग, देयर इज अ जोक व्हाट वी कॉल इन द गवर्नेंस एस्पेक्ट इज दैट इफ यू वांट, इफ देयर इज अ रिकरिंग प्रॉब्लम, डॉक्टर्स डू रेडिकल सर्जरी. So when a problem is recurring in terms of governance, you take that culprit on board, make him your colleague, make him your ally, or dono milke rohenge, make him your partner. Then the situation can be improved. Jaise shaadi kiya tha meena aur biwi, fir dikkat nahi hoti, dono saath milke they
take it.
So my request is that you get in touch with the police. Let police also get in touch with you. So ek jo rapo banegi one, and dusra they also understand what is the plight of the doctor. They also do not know. अपने काम में busy आप, they are as busy as you are. So आप अपने दुपहर यहाँ रो रहे होटल में बैठ के, वो अपने खाने में बैठ के रो रहा है. Issue ये है, why don't you people call them and tell us कि भाई ये दिक्कत है यार, this is the ground level reality and they'll understand. हम लोग casualty पे काम करते थे, सिपाही आता था ऐसे ही बोलने, डॉक्टर साहब तो पढ़े लिखे हो, मार दिए होता. Absolutely यही बात होता है, वो क्या बोलेगा? He cannot say डॉक्टर साहब complaint दे दो, फिर डॉक्टर कल को उसको बोलेंगे यार तू बदतमीज है, पिछले 10 साल तक चौकी पे तूने मुझे एडवाइस नहीं किया, तो नहीं फंसवा दिए. So, I mean, that is a very humble way of submission. कि डॉक्टर साहब छोड़ दो, आप तो पढ़े लिखे लोग, वो थोड़ा ना बताएगा डॉक्टर साहब कल को आप दिक्कत में पहुंचोगे. So, that is how it is.
डॉक्टर साहब ने कहा कि भाई हमने तो कोर्ट में गालियां ही खानी थी, गाली नहीं खानी, वहां डांट खाते हैं.
थैंक यू डॉक्टर राजीव एंड मिस्टर गोयल.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. All amazed our level. Now it would be very difficult for medical fraternity to go beyond that bar that our respected ESP sir Rajiv Sharma and session and our all the doctors has decided. So please go further. And now I request to please give a moment to first I request Subhash Sharma, advocate, to please give a moment to Dr. Rajiv Sharma. You are here and you motivated us and encouraged us and give us the... Now I request Devdutt Sharma, advocate, senior advocate in Ghaziabad, to please facilitate Mr. Mural sir.
Great session. And now we will move on to the next session.